let's terminate. So we have seen that different examples of regular grammar. We also have seen that all the grammars are not regular. It will depend whether a grammar is regular or not. It will depend upon whether it is right linear or dislinear, but not a mixture of them. Now we will proceed more. We will come to a point about regular expression. What is regular expression? As the definition given, that one way of describing the regular language is via the notation of regular expression. Now you have to visualize this relation first, that we have a regular grammar over here. For example, I mean, if I just arbitrarily draw, say we have a regular grammar, some regular grammar is there, suppose, just a minute, I'm sorry. Some regular grammar is there. And this regular grammar will generate some language. What we will call? We will call that as regular language. This language, so this is part of, you know, I mean, okay, I mean, I will write that letter. And this language should be accepted by some machine. That is what we call finite state machine. So this finite state machine we have not seen yet. We will see very soon. But now question is that how we represent this regular language. We represent our regular grammar with respect to some set of production rules. We have seen that. How we can write the production rule, we have seen that. Now how we can write the regular language? How we will express this? We express, obviously, one way of expressing with the help of English words. For example, language L equal to X, for example, something like this. For example, something like L equal to, say X belongs to 0, 1 star. That means some combination of 0, 1, 0 and 1, such that X starts with 0. What does it mean? Mean that X is a binary string, some combination of 0 and 1. Now, what is the combination? I am not interested. I am interested that X must start from 0. After the first 0, any combination of 0 and 1 is possible. Right? So, you can express a language like this, but this is not a formal way of expressing a language. A formal way of expressing a language is what we call regular expression. So now let's try to realize what are the different type of regular expression possible to express the language. For example, first one, you know, you have to understand these 5 points to create the regular expression for your own language. For example, starts from 1. What is given? That epsilon is a regular expression, indicates the language containing an empty string. As I told you at the very beginning of the automata theory class, we have discussed that empty language. That means a language having empty string. And I told you, there I have showed you that how we can represent that. By mistake, if you are not able to recall that, you can recall it from my previous video. So our first language or the basic one will start from this empty string. Then the next one will come. That is phi. Phi is a regular expression denoting an empty language. Now see, here we have a very crucial difference. One is empty string and one is empty language. We always remember one thing. We represent an empty string by a symbol epsilon. But there is nothing to represent an empty language. I mean, if I want to write and if I want to express an empty language, we express by a opening and closing brace having nothing inside. But if I want to represent a language containing empty string, we represent this one. So that means this epsilon represents empty string. Actually this is an empty string, you can say, or you can say this is a regular expression also, as is given over here. Now empty string mean what? It means that the idea of the empty string, maybe you will realize when we will go for this finite state machine. So let's wait for some time. Just for timing, you try to memorize it. And point number 3 is given that x is a regular expression where l is equal to x. So x is a symbol. X is representing a symbol. And this single symbol suppose representing a regular expression. So the language that will be generated from the regular expression will be denoted by L equal to this. Okay. Now we have a lot of recursive technique to generate more languages with small regular languages. For example, that's why the point number 4 come. Point number 4 say that if X is a regular expression denoting a language L of X. Okay, X is a regular expression which is, always remember, regular expression is a combination of the terminals and various other operators. Using those terminals and various other operators, we can express that. So we will see very soon. For example, to understand this, try to understand this point, that if X is a regular expression denoting a language L of X, similarly, there is another regular expression Y denoting a regular language L of Y. Then combining these two regular expressions in various ways, we can generate more regular expressions. For example, combining them in this way, that is X plus Y is a regular expression again corresponding to the language L of X. A union of the language L of X and L of Y, such that where we represent L of X plus Y, that means plus doesn't mean numerical addition. Here plus means actually you can say logical OR. So language of either X, language of either Y is equal to language of X union language of Y. Okay. Because if we know that X is a regular expression and Y is another regular expression, I can combine them to form a new set of regular expression by X plus Y. Now, if a new regular expression we find as X plus Y, then what will be the corresponding language? Naturally, the corresponding language with respect to this one, if there is X, let's take another color so that you can understand. So if it is x, then it is L of x. If it is y, then it is L of y. Now what we are doing, x plus y. So since it is x plus y, obviously language will be L of x plus y. So question will come that what will be L of xy equal to what? It will be equal to the union of the languages that is generated from the regular expression x and y individually. That means L of x and L of y. Union between them. Similarly, we can have a dot operation also, which basically we say a concatenation. That is, concatenation. That is, x followed by y. It's not numerical multiplication, okay? So, if x and y is again a regular expression, that means I can also say, understood. Now about b. That x dot y is another regular expression corresponding to the language L of x dot L of x y, where L of x dot y equal to L of x dot L of y. That means this is what we call concatenation. Similarly, third one is what we call about the, just what we have discussed, clean closure. It says that R star is a regular expression corresponding to language L of R star, where L of R star equal to L of R whole star. What does it mean? It means that if R is a regular expression, some irregular expression R, then we can say that capital R star is also a regular expression and its corresponding language will be L of R star, naturally. By the definition we have seen, if X is a regular expression, corresponding language will be L of X. So if R star is a regular expression, corresponding language will be L of R star, where the definition of R star we can say as L of R star as L of R whole star. You see that. So what does it mean? It means that the language generated by R, only R, not R star, language generated by R, if you put star over there, then the same language will be produced by this L of R star. Now, what does it mean? Take an example. Suppose R is, R is equal to A plus B. You see, A plus B is a valid production, regular expression with respect to this particular point A. I can say that A plus B is a valid regular expression, combining this as a plus. Why? Because I can consider only single A as a regular expression 1, single B as regular expression 2, and we are combining them by plus the point A as suggested. Now the R star, now question is that what is R star? R star will be equal, should be equal to A plus B whole star. So this is what actually I have said. You see, now L of R star, that means L of R star will be equal to this L of A plus B whole star. And what is this L of A plus B? This A plus B means R. That means I can say this is nothing but L of R whole star. And this is what actually you have said over here. Right. The whole star, you know, actually given something like this actually. I mean, with respect to the actual, what I have written over here should be something like this. L of R star should be equal to L of A plus B star. And L of B, A plus B means L of R. A plus B means R. So actually, you should say that something like this, you must say L of A plus B star. And L of A plus B, what? This A plus B means R. So I can say L of R. That means L of R star. This is what actually expressed in this point C. Now applying these three points in various way, we can find many more complex regular expressions in the automata theory.